Hi, this is Nagesh Prabhu, Professor and Head Department of EEE, NMIM Institute of Technology, NITE. In earlier lecture, we had discussed load flow solution by Newton-Raphson method using polar coordinates. Today, we shall continue to study the algorithm and flow chart for NR method using polar coordinates. The algorithm for NR method in polar coordinates, there are various algorithmic steps as indicated below. So to begin with, we need to form the y-bus for the given system. And we have to assume voltages for various buses. Now, for all PV buses, the voltages need to be specified. So Vi is equal to Vi specified, that specified magnitude of voltage need to be given and at an angle zero. Then Vi is equal to one at an angle zero at all PQ buses. Okay. Now, after specifying and assuming the voltages at all buses, then we need to begin the iterative process. At rth iteration, we need to calculate PIR at all the PV and PQ buses and QIR at all the PQ buses. Now, to calculate PIR and QIR, we need to use the formula as given here. So Pi calculated R is equal to Pi, which is equal to Gii Vi square plus summation k is equal to 1 to n, k not equal to I, Vi, Vk, Gik, cos delta ik plus Bik sin delta ik. Now, Qi calculated at rth iteration is equal to Qi, which is equal to minus Bii Vi square plus summation k is equal to 1 to n, k not equal to I, Vi, Vk, Gik sin delta ik minus Bik cos delta ik. So using these two, we need to calculate the active power and reactive power at ith bus, and then we need to calculate the power mismatches are also called as power residues sometimes. And delta PIR is equal to power residues or power mismatches, which is equal to PI specified minus PI calculated as using the earlier calculations. Then this is to be calculated for all PV and PQ buses. Then QIR, delta QIR is equal to QI specified minus QI calculated at PQ buses. Now, once we calculate delta Pi and delta Qi for rth iteration, we need to calculate the Jacobian elements Jr using a Vi R. Now, we need to compute delta delta R and delta Vr by Vr. These are the correction vectors using the inverse of the Jacobian multiplied with the power mismatch vector. So once this is done, now we are ready with the correction vector delta delta R and delta Vr by Vr. And using these correction vectors, we need to update the angle and voltage for various buses. So angle update is delta I R plus 1 is equal to delta I R plus delta delta I R at PQ and PV buses. Then Vi R plus 1 magnitude is equal to Vi R plus delta Vi R at PQ buses. Now, with this updated value of delta I R plus 1 and Vi R plus 1, we need to go to step 3 and iterate till the power mismatches are within the acceptable tolerance epsilon. For NR method, is depicted in the form of flow chart here. To begin with, we need to read the system data and formulate bus admittance matrix Y bus. Now, assume bus 1 as a slack bus with the voltage V1, which is equal to V1 at an angle 0. Assume bus voltage Vi is equal to 1 per unit and delta I is equal to 0 degree at PQ buses, and Vi is equal to V specified in terms of per unit, and assume delta I at PV buses is equal to
0. Now we need to set the convergence criterion, which is equal to epsilon, a very small number, and usually epsilon can be taken as 10 to the power minus 4, and maximum iteration count to be set to R max. This is mainly because it is expected that the system of equations of load flow will converge within this R max, and if not, then we need to stop the program. Now iteration count R should be set to 0. Now once R is set to 0, then we need to set the bus count I is equal to 2, because I is equal to 1 is the slack bus. No calculation or no updation is required at slack bus, and hence iteration count R is equal to 0 and bus count I is equal to 2 need to be set. Now for every bus there should be a check whether it is a PV bus or not. If it is a PV bus, then PIR need to be calculated using this equation, and once PIR is calculated, we need to find out delta PIR is equal to PI specify minus PIR, and we need to advance the bus count I is equal to I plus 1, or we need to increase the bus count by 1. Now we need to move to next bus, and again we need to check whether it is a PV bus. If it is a PV bus, same way it should be continued. If it is not, then for that particular bus which is not a PV bus, that means it should be a PQ bus, we need to find out PIR and QIR using these equations. Now delta PIR and delta QIR are the residues of powers are to be calculated using PISP, that is PI specified minus PIR and QI specified minus QIR. Now with this residue in bus powers to be calculated, and then we need to advance the bus count to I is equal to I plus 1 and complete the same procedure for all the buses. Now if all the buses are completed, then we need to find out the difference in the absolute value of the residue. Now let us see if in case delta PIR and delta QIR is less than or equal to that small value epsilon. If it is yes, then solution is converged. If not, then we need to evaluate the elements of Jacobian matrix. And once the Jacobian matrix are evaluated or calculated, then we have to find out what is the correction vector. Correction vector is delta delta IR and delta VIR by VI, which is equal to J inverse mismatch of active power and reactive power. Now, with all this correction vector calculated, we need to update the bus voltages and bus angles. So VI R plus 1 is the new value of updated bus voltage. VIR, that is given by VIR plus delta VIR, and updated value of bus angle is given by delta IR plus delta delta IR for I is equal to 2 to n. Now, once this updation is over, then we are ready to carry out the next iteration. So then we need to set the iteration count R is equal to R plus 1. Now, again, we need to check here whether R count or the iteration count is greater than R max. If yes, we have to say there is no convergence and we need to display the same and the program should stop. Otherwise, with the updated value of voltages and angles, we need to calculate the residue powers or power mismatches, and then again we will arrive at this condition wherein if the mismatch is less than epsilon, then we need to calculate the line flows and slack bus power, and once the line flows and slack bus powers are calculated, then the program will stop.